Hi, I'm Jason Stahl, and I'm here with Joe Keene, automotive video producer at Babcock's Media and ASE-certified technician with a strong background in automotive electronics. We're going to talk about electronics and the reassembly process next in the AirPro Diagnostics Garage. In our last video, we discussed considerations collision repairs should take regarding electronics when refinish operations are being performed. Today, we're going to be discussing the reassembly process and things to check to ensure the ADAS systems are working properly. Joe, what are some things repairers should do after reassembling a vehicle after repairs to make sure the electronics are working?
Well, testing all lights is a no-brainer. Let's say you find out the headlights don't work. Tracking these problems down requires highly skilled individuals. The DTC indicates a problem in the lighting system. It'll take research to find out where all the body control modules are and start troubleshooting to find the specific issue. The problem may be that a body control module and a quarter panel is connected to the vehicle's lighting system. Turns out, the module was damaged or a wire was pinched, but not cut. This shut down communication between the modules, which stopped the headlights from operating and set a code.
So assuming that the problem is not accident-related damage due to the vehicle being hit in the rear, it could become a big issue.
Yes, indeed. Being able to tell what is accident related or not has become more and more complicated. And in this specific situation, if left unresolved, you can have a very upset customer and the potential for legal challenges too.
That makes sense. So we identified that headlight problem. What about testing ADAS systems?
One thing you can do is put the vehicle in reverse to test the backup camera and backup sensors. Also test components from the repair related to an alignment you did or windshield replacement. A calibration may be required.
Thanks, Joe. In our next video, we're going to discuss the post-repair scan and why it's a critical step in the repair of today's vehicles. I'm Jason Stahl. Thanks for watching.